just wanna see you
shake that.
Every day I'm shuffling.
What's the matter?
More there? I'm gonna do my tarot reading now. Can I do the tarot reading now, Siren? You gonna be quiet? You gonna be quiet now? For your mummy? No, you're clawing me, look. You're putting marks on my arm, like the kitty cats. No, you be quiet while you get the tarot reading done. These dogs are not meant to distract, they're meant to help and guide. You miss Grandma. Oh, you're a gorgeous dog. Come on, you go. Up you go. That's better. Now I can do the tarot reading. Ruby, do you mind if we put some incense on?
Yeah, go for it. I don't know if my incense
is very manipulative.
Sarah, one of your friends, and you know, one of the people that possess you.
Mm-hmm.
All right, just hang on. Just wanted to do the light. So for the next 5 minutes, I want you to concentrate on what you want to know. Just sit there and be blessed and in silent. And tea is wonderful to have with a tarot reading. The guy that has made this deck calls it Tarot and Tea Days, where he does blogs or he does tarot and tea. So yes, this is the deck, as I showed you previously. A touch of magic, a touch of shadow, a twinkle of beauty, a sparkle in tarot. A feeling of mystery, a feeling of ponder. Shuffle the cards and take a wander. I'll just choose out that one, that mysterious one that pops out. Literally jump out of my hand sometimes. But I wanted that last card and that last card there. And these are your hidden aspects to your life that you did not know that need attention to, or you keep pushing aside, or you dismiss. All right. Hide them for the moment and just put them there, and then I'm going to get the deck out. It's hard to do with one of them. I'm going to take the deck out. I'm going to do some shuffling. Yes, we're allowed incense in this reading. Thinking very hard. about what the hidden aspects is to get the hidden, and we have to know what they are because you don't peek.
No, I'm just moving.
I have always promised my daughter a tarot reading and never done one for her because I didn't like the deck of cards. These cards. Oh, that one was going to jump. So we start with that. We have a card to start with. But first, I'm going to stop the deck, shuffle in there, and get Ruby to choose which side, which deck do you want. You can put your hands over it to feel. Feel a tingly or feel... Sorry, I'll put it closer to you. You ready?
I've been lazy.
Feel a tingling, feel a warmth, feel a repulsion. Those ones? Mm-hmm. But these ones are going quietly away. I'll just put them over here. I'm going to give it one more shuffle. Whoa, that card jumped out. That's what's crossing. Now what I do is I used to do it the other way. I used to lay out all the cards for the reading in front of the person, but the person would get overwhelmed by looking at the story and they'll be like, oh, what does this card mean? What does that card mean? They're not focusing on the reading. So lately I have learnt just to basically say, well, hell with it. You only get to see one card at a time. We'll start with the hidden aspects to my daughter's tarot reading. Ruby, the first one that really jumped out was the one on the right. Now, that funnily enough came up in my last reading. And I tried to put the card back and it jumped out anyway. And that is the... I can't read it from here. Four of Cups. Now, four basically is a primary number for closing the door and past. You can see there that the lioness is like dwindling over books. She's studying a cult. She feels a bit lost. She feels a bit lonely. She has three relationships in mind that is full and is blessed and that she likes. And she has... I just have to feel the character. The head staring at me. Alice is staring at me. And basically she is looking for a way or a destiny, or she's looking for something to lift her spirits up. She's very melancholy. She's been concentrating on everything she wants to do, which is academic and stuff like that, but she hasn't been concentrating on her feelings that much, and she really needs to open herself up to where she wants to be, what she wants to do, and basically take a more positive attitude towards herself first and then towards others. Does that make sense? Now in this also, I'm going to look at the book because my interpretation is my interpretation. As you can see, she's got three cups that she's reminiscing about. One I can say is for future, one that I say is current, and one that I say is past. But there's a cup that she always keeps close to her, and I think that's your family, especially your brother. He's always in your heart. He's something that will never leave you. But you're questioning whether these other friendships are going to leave you. Is it a stable relationship? And because you haven't had very much of a stable life with like a normal father, mother, growing up in your parents' house and having their love and your love around, and it's been a turbulent life, you tend to block people a lot quicker than they come. And you might come off as standoffish, a bit snooty, and a bit academic to other people. It doesn't mean you are those things, all right? It just means that's how people perceive you because you're not ready to open up to friendships and possibilities because of being hurt before. Now, what the Goliath says about this beautiful, beautiful depiction of Four of Cups is it's doubt, hesitation, lack of motivation and knowledge of oneself, inner questioning, being sarcastic and defensive, being passive, only concerned with self, which I don't think is true, right? I honestly don't think it's true. I think it's more like you're seeking this You're seeing things clearly and are realizing that you and you alone are the one that got yourself in this mindset, and you need to lift yourself out of it now. Does that make sense? That's one of the things that he was saying. You fear passion, you fear desire because you have a lack of it. You're not wanting to be involved with others. You daydream a lot, which is good. Daydreaming is good because it helps, you know, get your feelings intact and showing you directions of what you daydream is basically what you desire in your life. You got a lot of disappointment in your life. Giving away little energy and expecting more in return sometimes. Alright? Now this is something you got to be aware of. The reason why you want energy so much is because of your unstable childhood. And I have to apologize for my part in that. But what is amazing is the ability to change and to the foresight to see it. Now if you look at this other cop, this is the response to the hidden aspects of yourself. And I could be picking up one of your personalities rather than, you know, my boo or Ruby. Does that make sense? Because Ruby, you know, is one of your personalities. One that's definitely staying. Yeah. The Ebony I knew is gone. Does that make sense? And Ruby took over. So it would be nice to see Ebony again one day when she's like fully healed from her life and wants to pop up. Don't worry, I understand, because I'm no longer Cindy. I'm Jolie. I was Jezebel and that, but Jezebel, as I said, she died. So I understand exactly where you're coming from. And I told you, I got this in a previous reading for the reader, for the card, for the reader. So I understand what you're going through. Maybe I have been a bit self-absorbed and I haven't realized it, but I needed to be to strengthen myself to go out into the world, because I realized that if Puppy and Juma die, I've got no one to look after me, and I need someone to look after me. You need someone to look after you, and I'm doing the best I can to be there despite my own problems. Does that make sense? Now, this one here, the Knight of Pentacles. Well, you can look at it. He's absolutely majestic, right? He's a wizened warrior of the sky. He's got stability. He's material worth is there. And these are the aspects you've got to look for in yourself. And you have surrounded yourself with some men that give you those aspects that you need for yourself. But you are cutting it off. Does that make sense? From growing anywhere deeper or even into a love that where you can say, I'm in love with you, and feel your heart break the first time and then feel the flutters and stuff like that. It'd be interesting to see what your actual reading says, because these are the hidden things that you worry about, all right? Now, with this one here, I say he's about to take flight. Maybe he doesn't want to hear anymore, or maybe you don't want to hear anymore. That's what I'm picking up. He's got an Aztec feel about him. He's very wild and worldly. And it could be that this person's coming into your life as a messenger and you haven't met them yet. But it's something that you have to find within yourself. What I'm going to read to you in a minute, all right? And with this, you got to realize that a knight is someone who would be anywhere between the ages of 22 and above. To probably 45, my age, 44, 45, yeah. And a knight is well established in the sense that they've got themselves, they earned the title of the knight for being noble. Does that make sense? And they're a very noble sort of person. But this one is very well, not well off, but well established in his material world, and he's looking for a spiritual journey. And as you can see, he's very in tune with his spiritual journey as well. And I don't think you've met him per se, but because you haven't met him, there are things that you've got to find in yourself, and it will bring him to you. And you might find that this person might only be in your life for 3 months to 3 years or 3 weeks, but they're going to have a profound message that helps you stop being so lonely and closing off to other people. I'll just have a look at what Goliath says about this card. Knight of Pentacles. Man. As Ruby gets the tea to have with our tarot, I must say that the knight serves the queen and the high priestess and protects her. So this person will be a protective person, Ruby. And I'll wait till she comes back to read the rest. All right, Ruby's got her tea. It's always good to have tea with tarot. People don't have the divining tea leaves, hey? Now this, I love this card. I am in awe of it. I'm in awe of the symbolism, because if you look closely, it's got a lot of symbolism on the brow chakra of the bird. I wonder what kind of bird it is. I'm saying it's either an eagle or...
It looks like an owl.
I thought it was an owl too at the start, but I wondered.
Can I say, like...
The Aztec warrior hawk. It's a hawk. But I thought it was an eagle. You thought it was... I thought it was an owl when I first looked at it. I was going to say it's very wise.
Yeah, it looks like an owl.
It does, it does. But it's actually a hawk. Now that I look at it, I can see the hawk shape. But we got owl, eagle, and hawk out of this, so we might pay attention to all three animals, or all three creatures. Now, with this, it's attention to detail you have to do. What else is there? It's very hard to read this writing. It's very attuned to the material world, as I said. Can you read that? Sorry. For some reason, I can't read in the dark. I can only read in light of the daylight. Can you read it out loud?
Reading the keywords, yeah.
Yeah, just the keywords.
Attention to detail. Methodical approach, business-minded, material world, going the distance, seeing things from a higher perspective, responsible, endurance, persistence, overcoming obstacles, seeing the bigger picture, risk-taking, dedicated to a task, digging into a position and not moving, stubborn, needing to have things their own way, painstakingly searching for perfection, looking to face the facts, working tirelessly, seeing the bigger picture.
Now, if you think about yourself, just the other day you were saying you're a perfectionist and you've started a new project, which you're going to need some business reputation if you want it printed. So maybe this person that's coming in your life is going to finance something, and that's how you get to know each other. Because then a lot of entrepreneurs will find out startup companies or people at the beginning of, like, you know, doing something. And they'll give them funding and stuff like that. So that's something you can look at. But whoever he is, he's coming in your life with a definite purpose. And these are the aspects that were in your masculine side anyway. And these are the aspects that you're going to bring out. Like your ability to finish a project has to come to the standpoint or attention to, like, that sort of thing. And once once you finish a project... You'll be amazed how sad and glad and how much it becomes a baby and how much the tears and tribulation had helped you. Now, now that we've done the hidden aspects, we'll just put them away for the moment. And I'll put them over here. Let's have a look at where you are at the moment. Wow. Nothing can go wrong for you at the moment. Nothing can go wrong. It's a destiny card, Major Arcana, Wheel of Fortune. I don't know what your interpretation of the Wheel of Fortune, but you can see by this card, it's full of blessings. It is full of, everything is at a completion. You've done everything you could. It's time to move on, to bring more blessings in. Everything's gone to a new cycle. It's like with you moving house, you'll be blessed when you find the house because it'll be the perfect house. That's why it's taking so long. Somewhere that you can stay more than a year and you're happy with the owners and all that sort of stuff. That's the sense I'm getting why it's staying so long, all right? You've got to decide where you want to live, what you want from this place, and you'll get it a lot quicker. But with the Wheel of Fortune, oh my God, it is amazing. It's a cycle of life has been really traumatic to you. So for the next section of the cycle, it should be very blessing towards you. You'll realize who your true friends are and who are not your true friends. You'll realize who cares about you, who loves you. And you're basically getting every blessing in disguise. I cannot say much about this destiny card that you have to experience the abundance of the Wheel of Fortune. Because it just doesn't go wrong. Yeah, you can't do any wrong. Business-wise, love-wise, or anything, you cannot do anything wrong at the moment. Because it's a new beginning, it's a new cycle. You're saying goodbye to the old one. You basically, I mean, you think about it, it's number 10, the Wheel of Fortune. And 10 is, the first one is you got your number one is your individual self. And 0 is bringing your guides, your angels, and the higher power himself, or the higher powers, the higher lords, all right? Around you to guide you, and it's a step in like a spiritual movement as well as a physical movement, the Wheel of Fortune, I feel. Anyway, Goliath feels that the Wheel of Fortune could be, I can read it now. It shows that there's a change to circumstances. I mean, basically being a major arcana, it's a destiny card. You cannot fight whatever is happening here. It is for the best. There's a reason why I write everything happens. Everything's possible. And you just got to put your mindset to it. It's fate, opportunities, the wheel of karma. So, you know, what you put in is what you reap, is what you sow. And you've reaped some pretty good things in your life, even though you got unnoteworthy from it. I can say that as your mother. It's the laws of nature, providence, external circumstances shifting, success in reincarnation. So you're reincarnating an old self of yours and improvising it into your current self. It's financial or possession gain. It's fulfillment. It's resolution, destiny. Take a risk. Finally take some risks in life and they'll pay off. It's creation and manifestation of fortune, treasure and abundance. Basically destiny, fantastic events to come. Something positive in your life that is pre-decided in your destiny. This is all that basically is. And I basically said that to you, anything. You know, it's the Medias touch at the moment. To get that in your deck is amazing. You've had such a terrible luck. You've had bad events happening. So you got to change your reaction to them to be able to better yourself. Does that make sense? Doesn't matter what other people think about you. It doesn't matter what I think about you. It's as long as you're happy within yourself. And since you're not at the moment, you're going to have to do some really big soul searching and find that love for yourself so that you can be finally happy for however long we're incarnated for. Does that make sense? Mm-hmm. Now, what is crossing your path at the moment is the Page of Cups, the Sister of the Risers. Some young person anywhere between 14 and I'd say 32, 36 will be coming into your life. They're very emotionally stable, very introverted, very set in their emotions, but have got it together, you know, very wisdom, but young, so they've got still growing, so they're not always right, yeah. But whoever this person is should be coming in your life between the 3 months and 3 years. It could be 3 weeks and 3 days, though, too, if they're not already in your life already. This person I see has a massive aura, and their aura is blue, like a light blue, like you're playing with. and she's luminous, and she's dedicated to being gentle towards you. And I see it more as a relationship rather than a friendship. She makes your heart warmer, and it actually takes time for this relationship to develop because there's a lot of and ahhing about both sides, but it's a blessing that this person's coming into your life. I can see it extending more in that sense that she's a bit of a dreamer, but she is full of love and compassion, and dears are about change as well, right? They normally appear when you've got a change and you need gentle change rather than a drastic change. You need someone to be gently there for you. You need someone to nurture you. And you need to nurture yourself as well. Because the reason you're looking for these qualities in these other people is because you need it for yourself. And you've got to somehow try to give it to yourself. Does that make sense? And it's very hard. because we can take as much energy as we want from other people, but it's never satisfying as developing it ourselves.
Mm.
Does that make sense? Now, what Goliath says about this beautiful sister of the Rises, I think it is. Page of Cups. Hang on a sec.
Keep that on.
She's going to be coming into your life basically to help your Wheel of Fortune get into the right wave instead of this negative wave that you've been in. She's going to be an amazing person to know, okay? It could even be an older person that's young at heart. You don't know, you know. But whoever it is I see it more in the relationship than anything. And it's like a new relationship, all right? I don't know what that means about your old relationships. I haven't seen anything on that yet. New emotional starts. So it doesn't necessarily mean relationship. It's new emotional starts. A softer, gentle approach, creative energy. So you'd be very creative at this time. Remembering your goals and dreams, learning to trust yourself, direct growth, solid friendships, beauty, nature, self-forgiving, reaching out to others, psychic experiences. Yeah, I'd say that because Deers actually bring a lot of that psychic stuff as well to you to help you activate those gentle changes that you need in your life. Letting your heart lead the way, feeling optimistic, letting your feelings show, an emotional release, expression. So these are the things that you have to take note that you have to learn to do, because wasn't I saying that you're closed off to all of that? So this is a Wheel of Fortune energy, this destiny, and this sister friend of yours is going to be something to help you implement those changes, and you'll be happier for it. It will feel like this burden's lifted off your shoulder, and these yucky touches that you get and these yucky feelings you get don't overtake you too much. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
And you got to learn to protect yourself from outside forces. You can get rid of some of those that possess you by doing a binding and banishing spell, which I can teach you if you want. So let me know later on whether you want me to teach you that or not. I'll just draw a few more cards. This is actually... a card I got with my first reading when I first played with this deck, and it's one of the shadow cards that he designed and added to the deck, Goliath. Mm. Now in this you got the Starseed card, and as you can see, this person is majestic, and you are from Starseed. I can tell you that you're crystalline with a bit of indigo in you, and you're also Starseed, all right, because you came in 1997, which is the end of indigo and the start of crystalline, okay? And in that, I always called you the little star seed. You were my miracle baby that stopped me from having cancer. You were my miracle baby that the first thing I ever had that I felt love from. I'm not saying that Harley has not got his own importance, but he's got a different meaning to me when he first came to me. You know what I mean? At the moment, we're apart, and now we're together. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Now, with the star seed, this is about exploring higher consciousness, learning to... intergalactic things, and you got an interest in intergalactic things as well. It's like occult knowledge. This is what I'm getting it from. You get to be a deeper, more spiritual person by the next 6 months. And if you look at this reading in the next 6 months, or I do another reading in 6 months, or 3 months, or 3 weeks, whenever you want another one, right, you'll find the absolute difference in the power of this card. I'll read to you a Goliath rope because, as I said, it's one of the cards that he designed that's not included in normal tarot. And I feel it's very important with this card to actually read what he feels is its meaning. It's the last card. Beings that have seen and experienced life elsewhere in the universe, on other planets and on non-physical dimensions other than just Earth. You've done that? Did you hear me? That's something you'll be looking forward to. A fragment of the universe, a star child, galactic beings, ET guides, cosmic beings, higher missions, star galaxies, activation codes, commonly known as indigo, crystal and rainbow children, which is one of you. Palladians, Arcturians, and a Domanian, Siren, Orion, Reptilian, Avian, Feline, and other beings. These are the type of beings that are going to be starting to hang around with you, and you're just about to get rid of one of those things, that those voices that possess you and that. And what did you say the name was of the voice that possesses you? Just
the annoying one.
Yeah.
Sarah.
Sarah, you're going to be gone soon, because Ruby needs to move on. Now, in this card, we're connected to the star seeds. You're holding this card, chances that you two are seeking a higher level of self-realization. I'll go more into that card another day, because it's not, even though you're on that path, you've been on that path since you were a baby, because, you know, you listen to a lot of my stories when you're young, and then you learnt not to like our way of life, because we're very free, very gypsy-like when you were young, because people told you and me off for our beliefs at the primary school. And as I said at the time, I'd rather be a witch than a bitch, you know? Mm. And I'm not going to get into it. So I've held back. And then there was once when we were in court that you said, Mum, I can't explain the magic. Nobody believes. And from that moment onwards, you didn't believe in magic anymore, because I, like, you know, I'm going, how do I explain, you know, what's happening and what's been happening and all that sort of stuff. And then you closed yourself off to it, which most people do when they're in teenagehood, because they've got to deal with hormones and stuff. So it's time to reactivate to your roots. So you might be hearing voices outside your head, like in the sky, going, it's a galactic doo-doo-doo-doo, and all this sort of shit. I've heard it, and it spooked the shit out of me. And then you'll go on a path of acknowledgement, and you'll be returning to a higher level of being, and you'll be much happier. You'll find where home is, you'll find where heart is, you'll find a better self for yourself, and you'll get less possessed areas where you end up in positions that you end up in, you know what I mean?
Mm.
And I was possessed a lot when you were growing up, when I moved back home with Gma and shit. I hated it. That's what I said to you. I haven't talked to you about it because I didn't know what you felt about possession and whether you dealt with voices that take over you and stuff like that. So we'll discuss that on a more personal level on another day. The next card is the King of Pentacles. Again, it looks like your financial status is looking on the up, because you got a lot of strong men around you that are quite prepared to finance you, quite prepared to back you, quite prepared to spend money on you. This person is very, very sure of himself. Very material sometimes, too material in the way they act, you know. It'd be good if they balanced it with a bit, excuse me, a bit of emotion in this reading. Excuse me. Now, I'm not going to say much about the King of Pentacles, because I think both the man aspect self is more what you have to dwell inside yourself. So I'm just going to give you a brief outline of what Goliath says about it. Goliath becoming an entity in his own way. I went to the queen instead of the king. Right. Same page, that's why. Stupid me. Anyway. Dependability. This is something you got to get rid of. Kindness. Security. Structure. Businessman. Abundance. Success. Basically, with the filling of the fortune, that's basically guaranteeing financial success for you. And it will happen by 3 years. Three years, majorly. It takes 3 years to get the financial success that I'm seeing. One day you're going to look back and say, Mum, I didn't believe this would happen. Mm. You know? If I've got money, I don't know what to do with it. And it's all from your hard work. So please finish one of those projects that you start off with, because it's going to end up earning you a fortune. And this person here, the older one of the Pentacles, the older messenger, will tell you something about that and will enlighten you better than what your mum ever could. All right? Oh my God, did you hear that? Man came over my voice. Excuse me. The last card that I'm doing is the Tower. Now, I love the Tower. The Tower here is to depict as a burning foundation of an old tree, and it's basically, I know, it's burning away all the pain, all the torment, all the foundations that have been wrong. I know. They're a bit scared because their home is burning down. It's basically your whole foundation that your life is on, your core beliefs, are being rocked at the moment, and they need to be rocked, and you have to look at things in a different angle and a different perspective.
I don't have core beliefs.
You do so have core beliefs. It's the reason why we react the way we do. But this card, I love it when I get the tower, because it basically means I'm crushing down all those things that had me in a rut, and I'm getting through it, and I'm basically burning my way through it. It also can mean that you're burning things at both ends, and that you're, you know, tired, lethargic, and all that sort of stuff. That's what I find when I get the tower card. And that you can't be bothered, what's the use? Or you started so many projects, you can't work out which ones to do next.
That stuns me.
Yeah, so you basically, this would shake the foundations, and it's another destiny card, basically meaning that you cannot get away from it. It's coming in your life to clean up your life and give you a much better outlook on the way you view things. We get away with the right, but as I said, what you have to do is basically listen to your guides, and not only that, you have to literally change some aspects of yourself. Things that you might not have seen a problem that people might have brought up. I don't know. I find that I'm learning about you every day again, like I did when you were a child. And it's basically, I think it's time for those foundations. Oh my God. I just thought Titus was there, right there. There's a black cat, and there's no black cat there.
Where is Tyler?
Yeah. So you basically got to, get rid of that. And basically, it's like a swift, sudden change, turmoil, challenges, to be ripped open and exposed. You got to expect that with change, that you're going to be ripped open and exposed. You're lucky I wasn't filming you.
I was making faces of the dog.
Hello. Loss of control, wiped out, disaster, life lessons, force of cosmic energy, karmatic deck. That's the second karmatic deck. Explosion of energy, crumbling of belief systems, turmoil, chaos. Disruptions to the revolutions that rock and shake the foundation of something, upheaval and a meltdown. So they're things to be wary of and things to embrace. Don't have a meltdown when all the changes happen. And
listen. I'm not going to have a meltdown. I have a meltdown about everything.
Well, that's something you're going to have to learn. Maybe do a song about the meltdowns. Do a comedy sketch about the meltdowns. See them in a different perspective so that you have less meltdowns. Anyway, I don't know what you thought about my reading. One last card to close up. And that's the death card. That's what Goliath got in his reading. The death card does not mean death, girl.
Yeah, I know.
It basically means transformation, which is basically what I've been trying to tell you. You got to change. You got to embrace those cocooning days. And you've had your cocoon. Now it's time to be a butterfly and embrace change and transform your life into something perfect. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed the reading, Ruby.
Yeah.
And I'll put that as a video, and I'll put it on YouTube so you can watch it at any time you want. And, learn by it.
I make Doggo happier.
I'm trying to stop the video.
Yeah, I make you happy.
The video doesn't want to stop.
Another one, please fill up a cup. Don't mess around, we just want to see. You say it now, you want.